Don't give room in your life or in your family such that you are comfortable, that you are okay, and others in your family are not filled with the Spirit. What's wrong with me? Why do I find it difficult to surrender to God? Surrendering to Him many times will not come without some struggle, not with the Lord, but struggle within yourself. In surrendering to Him, when you find it a struggle, don't deny the struggle. Just tell Him to give you the grace. Failure to surrender to God is to make ourselves vulnerable in the hand of the enemy. In your life or in your family such that you are comfortable, that you are okay, and others in your family are not filled with the Spirit. Because the person the enemy might use might be your housemate. Say with you, all in my house shall be filled with the Spirit of God. When you are driving, where you ought to yield and you do not yield, what happens? What happened? Accident. In the driving lessons, they teach you as you drive along, watch out for this sign on the road. When you see this sign that called yield, yield where you need to yield. Because failure to yield will result into war accident. Is it easy to say that in life too, when we refuse to yield to the leadership of the Holy Spirit, oftentimes it leads to war? And one thing about the Holy Spirit, He will not strive with you. But when you know how to yield, to release where you need to release, and to withdraw where you need to withdraw, it brings a true life of fulfillment. And let me say to you, in surrendering to Him, when you find it a struggle, don't deny the struggle. Just tell Him to give you the grace. What did I say? Surrendering to Him many times will not come without some struggle, not with the Lord, but struggle within yourself. Because the real you that will often want to surrender is your spirit. But guess what? Your soul, your flesh will resist surrendering. Because some of you have been flogging yourself. What's wrong with me? Why do I find it difficult to surrender to God? But I'm saying to you, there's a way out of that. When you acknowledge the struggle and you call on Him for the grace to surrender, it comes just like that. It's amazing that even in the war front, when a man surrenders, you are not allowed to shoot him. Imagine in the economy of God, when you surrender to God, heaven forbids the enemy from touching you. Heaven forbids. So, but the enemy will put us in a place wherein we are struggling to surrender to God. Failure to surrender to God is to make ourselves vulnerable in the hand of the enemy. But today I command, I declare, this trouble season in your lives. Understanding that you have a biological father and you have a spiritual father, they are all human fathers, because I am told in an adage in a country that it takes a village to raise what? A child. Say, it takes a village to raise a child. So God is aware that in the raising up of a believer on the earth, they will need human fathers. But the human father only have what it takes to help you in the development of your soul and your body. And the real you is what? Is who? Your spirit. Say, the real me is my spirit. Say, I am a spirit being. I have a soul. And I live in human body. All our human fathers are able to do is take care of our soul, our body. They inform us, they will give us wisdom, they will teach us, they will train us, they will scold us. They are human. But here it says in that verse 9, furthermore, we have had human fathers. What did they do? They did what? Corrected us. And what did we do? We paid them respect. Shall we not much more do what? Readily be in subjection to the Father of spirits and live? Wow. Say, the Father of spirits. Who is the Father of spirits? God himself. Three kinds of discipline. The Father of spirit deploys. Not only the Father, even our human Father deploys this discipline. The first one is that they chasten us. Say, chastening. The word chastening simply means instruct. Instruct. A child that has no instruction will self-destroy. The number two discipline is rebuke. Say, rebuke. Which means to verbally reprove. So many times, as a spiritual father, as I begin to teach, or as a natural father at home, they will tell you, they will give you a verbal rebuke and say, no, that's you can do. That's wrong. In the same way, the Holy Spirit on your inside, the Father of Spirit, will also bring some chastening. Because a spirit-filled life is a disciplined life. And the third part of the discipline is courges, which means to flog. Now, this translates into physical discipline, not beating. Scourging necessarily is not beating, but physical discipline. I wrote here, all discipline must begin with instruction. Say that with me. This morning, child of God, I want to challenge you to understand that your call to a Christian life demands you to daily live a crucified life. Say, crucified life. And then number two is to what? A resurrected life. And number three is what? A spirit-filled life. Say with me, a crucified life, a resurrected life, and a spirit-filled life.
Dear friend, thank you for taking the time to listen to what I've just shared through this medium. I want to believe that you were encouraged, you were inspired by what you heard. Should in case you've never answered the most important question of your life, which is, what will happen to me when I die? I want to help you by telling you from God's word. Romans chapter 6 verse 23 says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. Which means that all you have to do is receive the gift of God, which is in the person of our Lord Jesus Christ. And how do you do this? Romans 10 verse 9 says, if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. So what do you have to do? Pray this simple prayer with me. Dear God, I come to you today, a sinner in need of a Savior. Save me now. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ, you are my Lord and you are my Savior. I believe in my heart that Jesus Christ died for my sin. He was buried, but on the third day, God raised him from the dead. Therefore, I am saved. Now, as simple as this prayer sounds, I want you to believe that God heard you and God has saved you. This was the simple prayer I prayed as a 12-year-old boy many years ago. God saved me. And I want to congratulate you for making this important decision of giving your life to Christ. This is not religion, this is relationship. And I want to encourage you to go forward in living for God. If there's any practical way I could be of any help to you, please feel free to communicate in any form or fashion through media, through email or phone call. I'll be more than happy to respond to you. Well, I believe God with you, that he who has begun this good work will carry you through. God bless you.